Let's work through question number two from chapter nine. So the question says, the manager of an automobile dealership is considering a new bonus plan designed to increase sales volume. Currently, the mean sales volume is 14 automobiles per month. The manager wants to conduct a research study to see whether the new bonus plan increases sales volume. To collect data on the plan, a sample of sales personnel will be allowed to sell under the new bonus plan for a one-month period. So we need to develop the null and alternative hypotheses most appropriate for this situation, and then comment on the conclusion when the null hypothesis cannot be rejected and when the null hypothesis can be rejected. So this first part, finding the null and alternative hypotheses. So our claim is that the new bonus plan is going to increase sales volume from the current amount. So we can show that as mu is greater than 14. The opposite of our claim is that the sales volume will stay at 14 automobiles per month, or it's going to decrease under this new plan. So we can show that as mu is less than or equal to 14. So now we need to figure out which one of those is the null and which one of those is the alternative. So the null hypothesis is always going to have the equality in it. So our null is mu is less than or equal to 14. Meaning the alternative is mu is greater than 14. So now, what would the conclusion be when the null hypothesis cannot be rejected? So if you cannot reject the null in this problem, that means that there's not enough evidence that the new plan is increasing sales. But if we can reject the null, what that tells us is that there is evidence that the new bonus plan increases the sales volume of your sales personnel.